Hello, welcome back to the Explore YouTube channel. So we are going to continue with this series of important Python concepts. So today in our bag, we have sets and dictionaries. So in Python, you can just represent a set using curly braces. In this case, I can see this is the first set A and this is the second set B. Suppose A and B are having different elements, suppose 1, 2, 3, and 4, and A is having 1, 2, and 3. So basically a set has this property that, okay, all of the numbers inside of a set are unique. So kind of it denotes that, okay, all of the numbers which are inside of a set has a frequency of 1. I hope that makes sense. So what are all the operations which we can perform? Let's take a look at it. So first operation is a.add5. So basically, suppose if I perform a.add5, this 1, 2, 3 set is going to convert it to 1, 2, 3, and 5. So 5 is going to be basically added to the set. Okay. Now, what if I again perform a.5? Will this set look something like this? 1, 2, 3, 5 and 5, will this look like this? No, that's completely wrong, because set has this property that, okay, all the elements are unique. And again, I'm saying this again and again. Therefore, 1, 2, 3 and 5 will remain as it is. Cool, let's move forward. A.remove5, it's saying that, okay, it removes the number 5 from the set. So basically, dot remove operation is going to remove it, okay? So 5 is going to get removed and I'm going to be left with, again, 1, 2 and 3, right? 1, 2 and 3 will be initially whatever the set I had, that will be left. Okay, so next operation is a greater than b. Now you might be like, okay, I have performed some operations like 4 is greater than 5, then this is no. But for example, 10 is greater than 5, yes, this is yes. So these were based upon numbers, right? But up here, this symbol, the greater than symbol, kind of not corresponds to number. This kind of corresponds to superset or subset, depending on whatever it is. So whenever I'm talking about a greater than, I'm talking about a superset. And whenever I'm talking about a less than, I'm talking about a subset. And we'll look at both of them. So both of them, we'll look at it. So A greater than B, it means that, okay, it's saying that checks if A is a superset of B. What do I mean by superset? So for example, this is set B, this is set A. And set A has, suppose, element 5, and set B has element 5 and 6. Is A a superset of set B? It means that, is A having all the elements which B is having? No. B is having 6, but 6 is there in A? No, it's not there. So this is going to return me what? False. So A greater than B is going to return me false. Okay, B greater than A, B greater than A. Even compared to this example, A is 1, 2, 3, B is 1, 2, 3, 4. So is A a superset of B? No, so false will be returned. Okay, B greater than A, it's going to check that, okay, checks if B is a superset of A. So is B a superset of A? Is B having all of the elements A has? Yes, 1, 2, and 3, A is there. But again, 4 is there. And I don't care, because as of now, B is having all of the elements which A has, or the numbers which A have. So this is going to return me what? True. Great. Now, there are two ways. The first way is, okay, I just use this greater than symbol, right? The second way is I can just use dot is superset operation. So A dot is superset operation B is going to check, okay, if A is superset of B. And again, I know for a fact this is going to return me false. And this is something I've learned from here itself. So there are two ways, using greater than symbol and using dot is superset. Okay, so many times in the MCQs and various examinations, you will be given only this operator and you might get confused, right? Because this is not a variable, this is a set. So therefore, this is very good concept to know. Okay, let's move forward. We have something like operations on set. Okay, so I'm going to continue here. A less than B checks if A is a subset of B. I mentioned that, okay, there are two operations, greater than and less than. So less than is nothing but the subset. So suppose the A subset is, or nothing but the set is like this, 1, 2, and 3, and B is nothing but 1, 2, 3, and 4. So it's saying that A less than B checks if A is a subset of B. So it means that, indirectly, it means that, is B a superset of A? Right? Indirectly, it means it is B a superset of A. I hope you get my point. Or, in other words, you can say that, okay, is 1, 2, and 3 present in B? Yes, it is, right? So I can say that A is a subset of B. And subset is a terminology, I hope, which you might be clear in terms of array as well, right? Subset, subarray, subsequence, and then so on. Okay, let's move forward. Another way, instead of using this less than, is using dot is subset, right? Dot is subset. Like greater than, dot is superset, and less than, dot is subset, kind of in that way. So checks if A is a subset of B. That's pretty much it. So in this case, this is going to return me true. And this is also going to give me a value true. Okay, A straight backslash B. So it kind of says that, okay, it's a union operation and it's going to give me all elements from A and B. So all elements from A and B are nothing but 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 1, 2, 3, and 4 is going to be getting returned from this very operation, right? This operation, union operation. Okay, the second one is A and B. It's nothing but the intersection operation. Common elements from A and B. What are the common elements from A and B? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, I can see are common. So this operation is going to give me what? 1, 2, and 3. Pretty much 1, 2, and 3. Cool, right? Now we have A minus B. Again, don't get confused that, okay, this is a mathematical symbol here, right? Again, this is it, right? So if I perform 10 minus 2, this is going to give me 8. But in terms of set, it's not the same. So it's nothing but difference operation. Elements in A that are not in B. Again, elements in A that are not in B. Suppose in this case, elements in A which are not in B. Is there any element in A which is not in B? No, right? So this is going to give me what? As of now, it's going to give me an empty set. But what if my array A was something like this, or not really an array, but my set A was something like this, 4 and 5. And my set B was something like this, suppose 5 and 8. So it's saying that difference of elements in A, very important, that are not in B. So in this case, I can see that 4 is not in B. So this is going to give me what? In this case, 4. In this case, right? Okay, great. A, then we have an inverted greater than symbol. B, symmetric difference, all elements except the ones common in both the sets. Cool. So what will happen is that, okay, I'm considering this set A and set B. What are all the common elements? I can see the common elements are 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3. So I'm just going to get all the other elements here. So 4 is the output, which is going to be up here. 4 is the output, which is going to be up here. As a matter of fact, let's just practice this. A is suppose 4 and 6. Okay, 4 and 6. And suppose B is nothing but a set having the numbers, suppose 10 and 4. So what are all the common elements? 4 is the common element. So what will be my output? 6 and 10 will be my output here. 6 and 10 will be my output. So again, it's just said here, all elements except the ones common in both the sets. Quite simple enough, right? Okay, and then we have simply 5 in A. 5 in A, it's going to check, okay, if number 5 is present in set A, and it's accordingly going to return true or false. So suppose I perform 5 in A, then this will return me what? False. But if I perform something like if 2 in A, then in that case, this is going to give me true because 2 is present in A. And again, if I want to check that if some number is not present in a set, so I can just use maybe like 3 not in set B, and it's going to check if 3 is not present in set B, and again, it's going to return true or false. So is 3 not in B? No, 3 is in B. So is this going to return me false? No, this is going to return me what? So by the way, this is going to return me false because true won't be there because 3 not in B, right? So 3 is already in B. So this is going to return me false. I hope that makes sense. Okay, let's continue. Now we are going to hop on to dictionaries here. D is nothing but a dictionary here. So in dictionary, usually we have something like key and value pairs. I hope you are clear with this terminology, key and value pairs. So up here, 12 is one of those keys, even is a value. Zoo is a key, zebra is a value, prime is a key, 19 is a value. Okay, what are all the operations you can perform on this dictionary D? Let's see. So D of 12, quite simple, gives the value of the corresponding key. So what is the value here? Even. So even will be returned here. Even will be returned here. Quite simple enough. D of 45, well, can I see any key with the name 45, right? No, I cannot. So it's going to throw me an error because key is not present. Because it's going to give me something like key error, right? And how to overcome this? That's the real question. So we can overcome this by using dot get. So if I perform right now, if I perform D dot get, the first parameter is going to take the key and this second parameter is going to take the default value. So first parameter is going to take key, second parameter is going to take the default value. So d dot get 45. 45 is present there? No. So it's going to, by default, it will give me a value of 0. What if I just write d dot get, very important, 45. And I have not even written something here. Like I have not even written the default value. Then by default, this is going to give me none. Very important with respect to MCQs. Okay, great. Max d dot key. So it's going to give me the maximum key. Same can be used for minimum. So if I just replace this max with minimum, then it's going to work the same. But it will give me the minimum. So D dot keys. What is the minimum of all of these keys? Again, up here, this will throw me an error because I can see that there is an integer, but again, there is a string here and then string. So it cannot compare properly, right? But suppose I had some dictionary in this way. 4 is having, suppose, 4 is the key having, suppose, value 50. And suppose there is another key, 1, having a value, suppose, 25. So what is the maximum of all of these keys? 4. So it's going to give me, in this case, it's going to give me 4. Cool enough. Now we have max d dot values, gives the maximum value. Same can be used for minimum. So again, It's going to give me the maximum value. What is the maximum value? 50, 25, 50 is the maximum. So 50 is going to be the output. Quite simple. These are a few things which you have to take care of. Now, how do I change the value here? So D of zoo is initialized with zebra. So I'm initializing it with elephant right now. So it's saying that, okay, changes the value for key specified. So in this case, the zebra won't be there anymore and elephant will come into the picture. So elephant comes into the picture. Okay, cool enough. Now we have something called delete D of 12. So it kind of deletes the specified key. So when I perform this operation, delete D of 12, then this key is removed. And if the key is removed, then the value is also removed, right? Then we have something like D 45 12. So this is another way of assigning a new key value parent to a dictionary. So suppose my dictionary was something like this. One is there and it is having a value, suppose 48. Now I am assigning D of 45 with 12. So my new dictionary will be nothing but 1 and 48 will be there. But a new key with value 12 will come here. That's pretty much it. So it's saying that, okay, adds the new key with specified value. This is the new key. This is the new key. And this is the new value. Okay, that's pretty much it. Okay, let's see. So ways to loop in set and dictionary. Very important. Ways to loop in set and dictionary. So suppose this is the set. So we kind of know how to loop in a list and a tuple, right? So we can kind of loop in this way. So for I in range n, where n is the length of a list or a tuple, then I can just simply maybe print all of those elements, right? So suppose there was a list here, so list 1 of I will be the answer here, right? I mean, kind of I'm printing the numbers in the list here, right? But that's not going to be following same for the set and dictionary. But let's see how we can do that. So suppose this is a set 1 2 3 4. So for x in set, straight away, right, straight away I can just do this. So for x in set, so x is going to correspond to each one of these elements here. Each one of these elements. So it's print x, so it's going to give me 1 2 3 and 4. This is what the output will be. By the way, the commas won't be there, so apparently this is going to give me 1 and I believe so 2 3 and 4, one by one, okay, not side by side. Okay, great. Suppose there's a dictionary, key is 1, value is 45, hello is one of those keys, value is welcome. Okay, so one of the ways is for key in D. For key in D, so I can just simply print key and the value can be accessed as D of key, and this is something I have explained here. D of key, D of 45, or by the way, D of 12 gives the value at the corresponding key. So I can just do that, D of key. But what if I want to say that, okay, I don't want to explicitly write D of key every time. In that case, I can just use something like for key comma value in D dot items. This is quite important, D dot items. If you don't write this, then this is going to throw me an error. So if you write for key comma value in D, then this is going to throw me an error, right? But if you have write, you have to write actually dot items. Okay, so for key comma value, key is this thing, and this value is nothing but D of key. But again, you can see here, right, I don't have to take the pain of writing D of key. I simply have the value, right? And I hope that explanation is clear enough. So this is pretty much it for the set and dictionaries, and these are pretty much the basic concepts which we tend to forget. So if you found the video helpful, please drop a like and do subscribe to the channel. Thank you.